Hey, what's up everybody? This is Jesse with Minimalist Accounting, and I have an awesome introductory video for you guys today on the basics of accrual basis accounting definition. We will look at the definition of accrual accounting and follow it up with a quick and easy example. So, are you ready? Let's dive in. Welcome to the heart of financial reporting. The accrual basis accounting. That's right, most accounting today is done under the accrual basis and you'd be doomed without learning it. I cannot stress how important this topic is, but hey, don't worry, I got you. Let's begin by looking at the definition. Accrual basis accounting recognizes and reports economic activities in the period the economic activity takes place. This is regardless of when the cash is received or paid. You can simply think of an economic activity as an activity that involves money or exchange of products or services. In essence, cash can precede or follow an economic transaction. Let's look at two key points, all right? So revenue is recognized when it is realized or earned. So for example, when you've completed a project, regardless of when the payment was received. And similarly, expenses will be recognized when your obligations are incurred, so as to say, you received an invoice. Just on a side note, to be aware of what's called the matching principle. It essentially states that expenses incurred during a period are to be recorded in the same period in which the related revenues are earned. Let me help you understand this better by giving you a quick and easy example that compares it with cash basis accounting, which recognizes revenue and expenses only when money changes hands. Let us assume that you perform services on day one, but received a payment for, let's say, $1,000 on day five. Under accrual basis, the $1,000 is recorded as revenue on the books on day one. That is when the economic activity has taken place. In this example, that would mean when the painter has done his job. However, under cash basis, the $1,000 is recorded as revenue on the books on day five. That is when the payment is received. And you guessed it right. The same theory would apply for expenses as well. In conclusion, remember that for accrual accounting, we are following the economic activity and not the cash transfer. It's really that simple. Look out for my next video where we take it a step further and discuss the two types of questions that you're likely to encounter under accrual basis accounting. Till then, happy counting!